years, ever since the Olympic Games of 4 years ago, when the gold medalist was Gaidarbekov. He has gone, and this is the new kid on the block, Matvey Karabov, 25 years of age, and through his first contest pretty easily against the man from Sweden. His opponent beat a Moroccan. Just in the corner standing statue-like is the man in red, Karabov from Russia. A lot of pressure on the Russians. They lost five boxers, two of them reigning world champions, two reigning European champions gone as well, plus another one. Coming up in about 15 minutes time, Britain against the United States in this very, very strong middleweight division. James DeGale against Sean Estrada. But for the moment, it's Russia against Kazakhstan. Out of the red corner, the southpaw, Matvey Karabov, top man in the world. The last 3 years, world champion in 2005, when the competition was held in China. He retained his title last year in Chicago, Illinois. And he's in against the best boxer of the Olympic Games in Greece from 4 years ago, a gold medalist in the welterweight division, 69-kilogram division, Bakhtiar Ateyev from Kazakhstan.
This is one of those contests, Jim. This is the physical chess contest now. Each of them trying to, watching each other, trying to make the other one make mistakes. No one will lead, look, because Karabov's the counter-punching southpaw. Ateyev on the back foot. Knows he can't afford to fall short. So he wants to try and draw the lead of Karabov.
Great start by the Russian against the man who went out in the world semi-finals last year, having moved up to the middleweight division, to the Venezuelan Alfonso Blanco, who's already through, as indeed is Ireland's Darren Sutherland. So two of the last eight places in the middleweight division filled. The third will go to the winner of this one, and at the moment the double world champion is leading the Olympic gold medalist, albeit at a lighter division from 4 years ago. Just falling short, Ateyev.
What he's actually doing there, Ateyev, he's not throwing the jab, he's throwing it as a long hook. But his main shot he's looking to land is the right hand to the body. So it's a bit of a distraction, that shot, for Karabov.
For what it's worth, Karabov is also the reigning European champion, won that title in Bulgaria. Well, oohs and ahs, but it was just a bit of a slip. Don't step to the side and then push your man down, from the referee to the Kazakh boxer. 2-0 to the world champion Karabov against a very, very good boxer from Kazakhstan. Such a pity they have to meet. It's the difficult, difficult top half of the draw. We've got the world champion, the world runner-up, the gold medalist from 4 years ago in the lighter division. Darren Sutherland from Ireland is through. James DeGale coming up, the American Estrada. Not much of a spread, and if you've got yourself in the bottom half of the draw, well, all you probably would have to worry about is a Cuban. Who would worry about a Cuban?
Yeah. Just Ateyev here just falls short. He fell short with a couple of attacks, and he was just his accuracy was just off a touch. And Karabov, he landed with one punch through there. A nice straight left to the body that certainly scored. But nothing in it. Ateyev has got to trigger his man off here. Trigger that first attack from Karabov, and then he'll try and respond. Two clever boxers.
And the Russian, Karabov, the southpaw, all in red, the clever of the two at this stage. 2-0, double world champion at the end of the opening 2 minutes. Cat and mouse stuff between these two. I must say, Richie, I would have disagreed with the panel who voted for Artaev as the best boxer of the tournament in Athens 4 years ago. There were an awful lot of contenders. There were two or three Cubans, yeah, including the wonderful Kindelin. And I would have put Amir Khan into that mix as well.
Well, Amir Khan, Kindelin, Rigondo, I mean...
Oh. Tyshchenko.
Tyshchenko.
Even the big super heavyweight, he was great, Povetkin from Russia.
Yeah, he was very good, wasn't he? So, yeah, a bit surprising that Artaev got it. I mean, he performed well in those games. Let's get that right. He was very well, but he boxed very well. But to be the best boxer of the tournament, not for me.
Well, he's boxing pretty well here. He's closed the gap to a single point, 3-2 to the man in red, midway point of the second round. And it's livened up a little bit now. Karpov being very clever, encouraging his man to come to him. There's that fast right hand, moved out of the way, didn't land with it. Well, RTF has retained an awful lot of that welterweight speed. But then middleweights are no slouches. We've seen a couple of bangers so far. Blanco from Venezuela, Darren Sutherland from Ireland, who stopped his man with 4 minutes to go. They'll meet for a place in the last four, and that's the medal stage. That was a good shot with the right hand by the man from Kazakhstan.
A lot of the time, Jim, a contest like this, when they're so evenly matched, it's not just a physical battle, it's a mental battle. Who cracks mentally? Who's going to come forward? Who's going to make the mistake? And at this level, you've got to be so strong mentally. You have. That's good boxing there from RTF.
Is he going to spring a surprise? We have seen two Russian world champions go out, and a third Russian world champion is behind at the halfway stage. What a good round that was for Bakhtiar Artaev.
Yeah, he got his act together here. He moved the feet in better. He was more accurate with the shots. Started to land with the right hand. And also long left hook work. There's that straight right hand. RTF just made a mistake there and got caught again. Just coming off the ropes. And another mistake. You cannot afford to make mistakes at this level, as Kurobov has just found out there. But better work from RTF. Little left, right uppercut there. Getting closer to his opponent. Straight punches. End of the round.
Well, you talked about that mental strength, and we saw in the featherweight division, Lomachenko from Ukraine having the mental strength to beat the reigning world champion Selimov from Russia. Look at that. Nothing between them in the first round, but a great second round by the man of blue from Kazakhstan. Remember, looking for a second successive gold medal, and at a different weight division. He was unstoppable and unbeatable in Athens 4 years ago in the 69-kilogram division. And RTF is leading 4-3 against the double world champion and reigning European champion Karabov from Russia, who's just pulled one back. And the Russians really cannot afford, in terms of prestige, to lose a third reigning world champion here in Beijing. Selimov gone, Vodopianov gone, Karabov still there. And back in the lead again.
Yeah, Artaev is just waiting a split second too long here. He's looking to land that straight right hand, his rear hand. But in doing that, concentrating on that move, he just now and again gets too close. And Karabov just steps in there, counter-attack, and just nicks the point.
And this, Richie, is a contest for the purist, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely.
Great little exchange. Karabov just that, well, millisecond first. There was nothing in that at all. I thought Artaev actually might well have landed, but the judges will have pressed one button. Went to the man in red. Just about deserved it. So Karabov, having been behind, has come back and is back in the lead again. RTF to try to cut off his escape route. You can watch this all day.
Yeah, split second timing, you know. You make a mistake here, bang, your opponent's got you.
Well, either James DeGale or the American Sean Estrada coming up will meet the winner of this one.
And you know what, Jim, you can't afford to make a mistake physically in this side of the contest or mentally. You just switch off for a second, like Korobov did there, you get caught.
End of the round, conceded a point, and he's only one up at the halfway stage. Or sorry, the halfway stage going into the last round. We beg your pardon.
Great contest, it really is. Straight right hand there from Artiev. Korobov is always looking just for that little counter or that counter attack, just stepped in there, and again, because Artiev just took his eye off the ball a little bit, just lost a bit of concentration. But here towards the end of the round, one shot got through there.
Was that a legal blow, Richie? He may well have just turned the wrist over at the time, but hard to say from that angle.
I think that initial jab, straight left, got home though, Jim, there. Brilliant, I could watch this type of contest all day long.
Well, two of the gold medal favourites in this middleweight division are meeting in the second series. They both come through fairly comfortably. Nice little touch of gloves right at the end. A lot of respect being shown here. They didn't meet in the World Championships, but the Olympic gold medalist from the 69-kilogram division 4 years ago has pulled one back, and it's seven apiece between him and the man in red, the double world champion, Korobov from Russia.
Well, he's got through the couple of shots here, Artiev. The first one was a long left hook. When they come together now, they've still got to maintain just a little bit of a gap so they can work.
Well, this would be a major coup for Kazakhstan and a pretty calamitous defeat if Korobov goes out. Russia have already lost two of the reigning world champions, another two Russian boxers who are reigning European champions have gone, and Korobov suddenly is in a little bit of trouble. RTF has boxed very cleverly against the southpaw. Korobov is holding, and well, the Kazakhstani has pulled up another one. He was nearly guilty of using the head there. Korobov needs to close this gap. Remember, it's Europe against Asia, and a lot of the close decisions have not gone the way of Europeans. We'll just leave it at that, Richie. But at the moment, Korobov needs to score points, never mind leaving it to count back. Lebsiak, the great Alexander Lebsiak, gold medalist in Sydney in the light heavyweight division, senior Russian coach, is incandescent. Is he going to see another one of his world champions go out, and very much the gold medal favourite for this one?
RTF now, they have definitely told him that he's ahead.
A little clip on the chin by Korobov, didn't score.
He seems to be sitting back now, more RTF.
Well, this is going to be a calamitous result for the Russians. If Korobov doesn't do something, and he's only got 30-odd seconds, he needs to be a little bit more adventurous, Richie. He can't stand back and hope to do something on the counter with no time at all. He's got to come forward and do it himself, and he's conceded a shot, and it's going to be defeat for a third Russian world champion.
Incredible, he's so used to having it his own way, you see, as regards to being a counterpuncher. Now he's got to come forward, he's been brought out of a comfort zone, and he's making mistakes, walking onto shots.
And RTF has boxed wonderfully in the second half of this contest. Korobov seemed to dominate the early stages. RTF has come back, and the man who won gold in Athens in the welterweight division and took the Val Barker trophy for the best boxer won that last round 4-0 against Matvey Korobov from Russia, not just the European champion but the double world champion, and a third Russian world champion has gone out. This was the best opponent any of them has faced, certainly. But Korobov was expected to win this one, and he hasn't won it. And there's every chance now that RTF can win a second successive Olympic gold medal in a different weight division. Gold in Athens at 69, a second victory at middleweight here in Beijing 2008. And the Russians will be very disappointed, but a terrific performance by the boxer from Kazakhstan.